Welcome to today's lecture. So today we will be dealing about the projects, policies, frameworks and initiatives in the context of environment and ecology, right? So this is part 16. So let us see the topics. The first topic is Andrex project, what it stands for, okay? Later we will see draw toolbox, bambunomics. The term bambunomics itself is, you know, derived from the bamboo. And next, the project replan. So replan stands for reducing the plastic in the nature. Later we will see about the one mobile app called as M Hariyali, which is started by the Ministry of Environment and Forest, right? Later we will look at the One Dhan Vikas Kendra's initiatives. We already seen this karyakram in last class, okay? We will look at the Green Climate Fund and how it is funding the projects. Later we will look at the Operation Clean Art, Green Good Deeds Campaign, Project Dolphin, Green Credit Scheme, Carbon Disclosure Project, Earth Hour by WWF. And finally, strategy on resource efficiency. Andrex project. So what does Andrex project stands for? It stands for Antarctic deep water rates of export. So here the amount of the water that goes deep in this region are transported to different regions, right? So recently scientists have found by this project that has studied the physical, biological, chemical properties between the 2008 and 10, they found out that these kind of biogeochemical processes that are occurring in deep seas, somewhere in the deep seas, will determine the ocean's capability to absorb the CO2 from the atmosphere. Please do remember, in the CO2 cycle, oceans play a significant role. It absorbs the CO2 to convert them into carbonic compounds, right? So this enhances our understanding between the linkage of southern ocean, that is next to the Antarctica, and atmospheric carbon dioxide levels, right? Draw toolbox. This is one of the important topic. So recently at the 14th conference of parties of UNCCD, they have come up with the draw toolbox, right? So here I have to make one correction here. So New Delhi declaration, I said in the recent class about the UNCCD, UNCBD, right? It is not UNCBD, it is CCD, that is the combat desertification, okay? Please do correct that. So at this conference, they have come up with toolbox. What is this? This is a knowledge repository. It is a one kind of web page where the vulnerable society, vulnerable countries will have the information or the knowledge how to tackle, to droughts better, right? Bambunomics. So this has been launched in the COP14 of the United Nations Convention on Combat Desertification. So this is a win-win situation for the tribals as well as the afforestation initiatives. How? So tribal people are the most knowledgeable people about how the bamboo plantation is being made, right? So with their aid, so afforestation initiatives by using bamboos will be done. So this, on the other hand, will also aid the livelihood of the tribals, right? Project replan. As I said, replan stands for reducing plastic in nature. So this is launched by the Khadi and Village Industries Commission. So what does it aim? It aims at making carry bags with 20% plastic and 80% cotton. So thereby absorbing the plastic waste in our environment. The next topic is about the mobile app M Hariyali. See, Hariyali ka matlab greenery. Okay. So this is the initiative by the Housing and Urban Affairs Ministry. This to engage or to involve the common citizens for the planting trees, otherwise called as the green drives, right? So this app helps in when you are planting any new plants, it automatically geotags those plants. So this information on the planting plants will give the nodal agencies about this information, right? So this contributes to Green India mission as well. One Dhan Vikas Kendra initiative. We have already seen this about this scheme in our last class. So these Kendras have been set up. This has been implemented by the Ministry of Tribal Affairs and by TRIFED as acting as a nodal agency. So what does it they do? They have to promote the livelihood of the tribal gatherings. Okay, so how so this improves the value addition of the minor forest produced by the tribal gatherers, right, and artisans. So this will act as a kind of marketing and value adding to these products. So non-timber forest produce. So this is expected to raise the value of these products by from 20 to present 20 to 60%. Green Climate Fund. Recently, $43 million has been used to aid certain projects in three coastal states of India, that is Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, and Maharashtra. Okay. So by using this fund. So if you look at in the partnership of United Nations Development Program. So if you look at the background of this fund, it has been set up in 2010 by UNFCCC financial mechanism to adapt to the climate change. Okay. Next topic is about the Operation Clean Art. So Clean Art, this is to stop the smuggling of the mongoose hair. So this is conceived by the Wildlife Crime Control Bureau of India. So this aim to ensure that the mongoose hair brush trade should be closed across our boundaries, right? So additional information, mongoose, he's been protected under Schedule 2 of Wildlife Protection Act. That matlab iska like any trading is considered as illegal. Green Good Deeds Campaign. So this is initiated by the Ministry of Environment and Forest. So this is to sensitivize common citizens and students. Like they have given a set of good actions which by following will improve our duty towards our environment and contribute to Green India, right? Project Dolphin. So government is planning to come up with this Project Dolphin in line with the Project Tiger. Okay. So they have already been asked this question in UPSC prelims, right? So Gangetic Dolphin. So this only lives in the fresh water. So this is considered as the national animal. And apart from this, this has been found in seven states, that is Assam, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Bihar, Jharkhand, and West Bengal. Okay. So this is protected and the Schedule 1, Appendix 1 of the sites, and Appendix 2 of the CMS, the Convention Migratory Species, otherwise called as the Bonn Convention, and it is regarded as endangered under the IUCN Red List. Green Credit Scheme. So our Forest Advisory Committee has approved implementation of this Green Credit Scheme. Okay, so what is this scheme stands for? So this considers forest as a trading community. So please don't get confused about this. So what does it do? It takes the degraded land and involves different agencies to convert the degraded land into proper forest. So after a certain period of time, like 3 years, these forests can be used by these agencies and be given to the industries which are in need of such kind of forests. Okay, that might be the paper industries, etc. Right. So this is kind of a win-win situation. Like we are addressing the afforestation process, and after a particular time, we are also addressing the demands of our different industrial areas. Right, for the development. Carbon disclosure project. So this is a global disclosure project that enables the companies, cities, states, regions to measure so their environment impact. So this collects different self-reported information data. Okay, so thereby it gives us a holistic information regarding what is the amount of the carbon that is produced and what activities have been taken to reduce this carbon. EDTAR. So this has been initiated by the World Wildlife Fund in 2007. So this has been addressed in on the last Saturday of March. So what does that do? In that particular time, civilians for the 1 hour we switch off their energy based lights, fans, etc. And it creates a kind of awareness and of the different citizens towards conservation of wildlife and aiming at addressing the climate change. Next topic is about strategy on resource efficiency. So Niti Aayog, in the collaboration with European Union, has released this strategy. So according to this strategy, so they have come up with the sustainable public procurement. So whatever the government is procuring, so they want those products or services to be sustainable. So according to that, they have planned this strategy, right? So this is developed with the recommendations of Indian Resource Efficiency Program, right? So let us meet in next class. Till then, take care. Please do continue with your preparation. Till then, take care.